really want an iced coffee. Should I go make an iced coffee? I'm gonna go make an iced coffee. Can't even get the straw in my mouth. How soft does my hair look? Shout out to my colorist. You a real one. What's up, guys? It's Cassidy. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm doing the long-awaited. Oh my god. Literally, since I freaking dyed my hair blonde, which was in December of 2017, I've been promising you guys a hair care video, but it's finally here. So the reason why it took me so long to put this video out was because it really did take me a couple of months to figure out exactly what products I love for my hair being this blonde, and just like everything is so well thought out when it comes to this hair. So to have it this light and still be like decently healthy, it's just a blessing. And I'm gonna give you guys the whole process today on how I keep my hair so healthy, how I keep my hair soft and actually touchable, not like a Brillo pad. Because most people that do have this hair, their hair ends up feeling like rough. I do several steps to try to avoid that as much as possible. Having this hair color, you kind of have to take it with a grain of salt because you're not gonna have the healthiest hair. Like, the whole process is, that's just what it does to your hair. So I'm first gonna talk about the salon that I went to. I go to Mizu Hair Salon. It's in New York City on Park Ave between 59th and 60th, and my colorist is literally my everything. Like, I love this woman so freaking much. She kills it with my hair every single time. And I went to her to get like the whole first process done, like from root to tip. It took about like 7 to 8 hours, I would say. We were there the entire day for my hair to just really lift. And, you know, the color took a super long time. And if you don't know much about color, you don't realize, like, your hair cannot take that much bleach. Some hair types will fall off doing what I did. Luckily, my hair was very healthy. Me and my colorist always say, like, if I didn't have virgin hair that was not colored at all, I don't think I would have been able to do this. Like, I would have had to wait to have completely, like, not colored virgin hair to be able to get this blonde. Because if I had processed hair underneath my natural brown color, it wouldn't have lifted the same and it wouldn't have come out, like, as even. There just would have been, like, so much more complications and more risk of, like, my hair actually just falling off, like, burning off. Bye. My colorist, her name is Marta. She did an amazing job. I love her so much. She got me to this color while really being careful with my hair. Like, her number one concern is always the health of my hair. I definitely have had some breakage, not because of the color process, but just because afterwards your hair is very it's very sensitive, so when it gets wet and you try to brush it out, it breaks really easily because it's like very like elastic when it's this light and this processed. So I definitely have to be really careful when it comes to like styling my hair and, you know, pulling on it, combing through it. I have to be a lot more careful. So the breakage that I have had has only been like up here or like around the edges of my hair, which is fine because it literally ends up looking like baby hairs anyway. But I will say, if you guys are in the New York area, please, please go to Mizu Salon and ask for Marta if you want to get color on your hair. The person that cuts my hair, his name is Steven, and he is my favorite person ever. He always does such like a cool, edgy cut on me. Like, it never looks like one of those mom haircuts. Not to offend any of my mothers out there, because y'all are moms. Don't come at me, but you know, even moms don't want a mom haircut. Like, come on. He just always makes the haircut so cool and edgy. It just falls in all the right places, and I absolutely am obsessed with it. So if you're gonna go to Mizu Salon, ask for Steven for haircuts and Marta for hair color. Take my word for it. You guys know I always have my hair on point, and it's literally because of them. I also want to let you guys know that before coloring my hair this color, I really almost knew nothing about hair color. I just knew that I was able to do it because I hadn't had my hair dyed before, so I knew it was gonna be an easier process. But having Marta, my colorist, really walk me through everything. Like, she's told me everything to do when it comes to styling my hair. She's told me about, you know, products like the masks that I'm gonna show you in this video. She's taught me so much about just like walking me through the process of having double processed hair. And for that, I'm seriously so grateful because it really has saved the health of my hair. So I have been talking for a while now. The important part. Let's go through the steps of how I treat my hair, how I keep it healthy at home, and how I make sure it doesn't turn yellow, because that's a big thing that happens with double processed hair that I'll talk about in a little bit. I'll talk about it when we get to it, okay? This whole hair care process is pretty much gonna be what I do in the shower and how the products that I use to style it afterwards that really help with like the softness and smoothness of having this hair. First thing, shampoo and conditioner. I don't think you guys are gonna be surprised by this because it's just been my ride or die, and it is the Hair Food shampoo and conditioner. They have a bunch of different like flavors. I want to say flavors, but you guys know what I mean. But this one is the moisturizing shampoo and conditioner. It is infused with honey and apricot fragrance. It's paraben free and it's mineral oil free, and this stuff is just so good for my hair. Like, oh my gosh, it's amazing. They have different types. They have ones for different hair types, but the one that I use, since my hair is dry and it is, you know, very delicate, it needs as much moisture as possible. So I use the moisture shampoo and conditioner. And I also love that it doesn't have harsh chemicals, because it's like, I mean, I already go through a very extensive process of putting harsh chemicals in this hair, like bleach and all that stuff. I need something in the shower that is gonna clean my hair without adding more harsh chemicals and more damage onto it. So this is my baby right here, Hair Food honey apricot moisture shampoo and conditioner. It's all I use on my hair, and it is so good. So that's what I use to really cleanse my hair, condition it, clean it out. And the next thing that I do, I mentioned this hair turning yellow. So one thing that my colorist told me is that when your hair is bleach blonde, basically the, oh my god, I forgot what she said, but it was like, I forgot exactly what she said, but it's basically like the hair follicle is like open now, since it doesn't have your natural hair color like protecting it, like each strand. Why can't I think of the words? But anyway, since your hair is like at such a vulnerable state, you really have stripped it of all its color, the hair follicle is like open now. I'm not like a professional. I am just repeating what the professionals told me in the best way that I possibly can. So basically, your hair is very like, it's open right now. Like, it doesn't have like a protective layer over it. So it absorbs the pollutants in the air and like all around you very, very easily. So with that happening, your hair can end up turning like a yellow tint. And I'm sure you guys have seen it in some of my videos. Like, some of my videos, my hair will look super white and like really fresh. And then maybe like a week or two later, you'll see that my hair does have a little bit more of a yellow tone. So what you do for that to like fix that is you can tone the hair. You can go to the salon and like pay for, you know, a toner, but sometimes that can be like kind of out of the way. So what I do is I use a purple shampoo, and the one that I use is Shimmer Lights by Clairol. This is the best purple shampoo on the market. I don't care what anyone says. I think it is the best one. I absolutely am obsessed with this purple shampoo. I just put this purple shampoo onto my hair and I let it sit for about 5 minutes while I do all of my other stuff in the shower that I have to do. Like, I'll either shave or I'll just wash my body while I have this sitting in my hair. The deep purple pigment of this shampoo, while it's sitting in your hair, it really cancels out that yellow tone, and for me, it makes my hair white again. I like for my hair to look literally like almost white. That's when I'm happiest. But when it starts getting like those yellow tones in it, like, it bugs me so much. So being able to have this purple shampoo at home and just letting it sit in my hair, and then when I come out of the shower, my hair is perfectly toned. It's not yellow anymore. One thing that I will say, this is amazing for toning your hair. It's amazing for stripping that yellow tone that blondes can get. But It definitely is not a shampoo, like a moisturizing shampoo or anything. I don't use this shampoo to really like clean my hair, my scalp. You know, I don't use it as like a cleansing shampoo. I don't use it to get that clean feeling in my hair. I solely use this shampoo to just tone my hair. While this is toning your hair, it can be known to make your hair a little bit dry. But the reason why I love it is just because it's so good at the color that I'm okay with taking an extra step to bring the moisture back into my hair when this does like take some moisture out. Because if you use this on its own and you don't put any conditioner in after using this, it could definitely be a little bit dry. Now they do have a Shimmer Lights purple shampoo and a purple conditioner. I have tried the purple conditioner and I just feel like the conditioner is like doing both the shampoo and the conditioner, it's way too drying on my hair. So I really only use the shampoo and I'm really, really happy with it. I kind of just took the conditioner out and the shampoo just does the perfect job. I did it recently, so I did it about yesterday. So you can see my hair right now is like that perfect like ashy tone. It's blonde, but it's more on like the whiter side than it is blonde more on the yellow side. So like I said, that shampoo can definitely make your hair feeling a little bit dry, and I am such a freak when it comes to my hair. Like, I will not let my hair feel dry. I do hair masks, and this was recommended by the manager of the salon that I go to, Marissa. Shout out to you, Marissa. Wow. I am so freaking glad that she told me to get this because I use this mask about twice a week. So I know that's extensive, but listen, if you want to get this blonde hair and you want your hair to be healthy still, I mask twice or three times a week and I leave it in for like 10 minutes. I don't care. Like, I am just so dedicated to keeping my hair healthy because I want this blonde to be good. I don't want it to be like, oh, I went blonde but my hair was falling out, because I've heard so many stories like that. So I am super dedicated to just keeping it really, really healthy. Is by Kérastase, and it is the resistance mask. Everything from this line is like in French, so it's super confusing. I never buy anything on my own without like being recommended because I have no idea what the hell any of this stuff means. The title of it is Resistance Mask Force Architect. I'm totally butchering that. I'm so sorry for my French people out there. I'm sorry. I don't know how to read any of these titles on Kérastase, but I freaking love this product so much. This is the thing that, like, I don't care about using the purple shampoo because even though that makes my hair dry, when I use this afterwards, it is like, it's like I never used a drying shampoo in my life because it makes my hair so soft and it's so moisturizing. I absolutely love it. So the next thing that I'm going to show you guys is how I go about blow drying my hair. So I know everyone is going to say that, you know, you should use as little heat as possible in your hair when it's this color, and that's very true, but let's be honest, like, I'm not following that rule. I do like to blow dry my hair. Now, I don't blow dry my hair every single time I wash my hair just because that pulling on the hair, it can really damage the hair. Plus, blow drying my hair, it just takes so long and it's very tiring. But for the purpose of this video, I want to show you guys how I get like that smooth, perfect hair, even though my hair is at such a high level of processing. So the first thing that I go in with when I come out of the shower before I blow dry my hair, so it's basically just like a blow dry balm. Before you blow dry your hair, you put like a dollop of this, spread it throughout your hair all evenly, and it's almost like a blow dry conditioning treatment. And if you're not blow drying your hair or you're not putting any heat on your hair, you won't need this because it only activates with heat. It's for dry and brittle hair, so when you put this on, it's activated once the heat hits it, and it makes my blow dry so much easier. It makes the hair dry faster because this hair takes forever to dry as well. Once I blow dry a strand of my hair, it is so soft. I run this all throughout my hair just to really lock in that moisture, and it makes the biggest difference. It leaves my hair so soft. Like, I am obsessed with this. And the last thing that I do is I actually got a sample of this at a Redken event that I went to. And it's by Redken. It is the Diamond Oil Glow Dry. So it's a blow dry shine oil. So I kind of use this to add the softness to my hair and make my blowout that much easier. And then I go in with this right after I put this in before I blow dry my hair. I put this in to just add that shine to my hair. So you can see for such processed hair, my hair is pretty healthy. It's pretty shiny. Like, it looks soft and my ends are not completely like Brillo pads. Like, I would say for having double processed, my ends are pretty soft. Oh my gosh, this smells so good. So not only will your hair look soft, will it look shiny, but it'll also be smelling good. Like, really, really good. After I blow dry my hair, I'm like, it smells so good. I love this stuff. So yeah, these are just, I wanted to tell you guys about these two just because they're my favorite two products to go in before I prep my hair for a blow dry. Wow, I can't believe I got through that. So that, you guys, is my entire hair care routine. That's how I keep my blonde hair from turning a really ugly yellow color. It's how I keep this hair soft, moisturized, healthy, and from breaking. Thank you for sticking with me through this because I know it was a lot of steps. I know, girl. Trust me. I do this. But I promise you guys, it's worth it. I am so obsessed with my blonde hair. I am so grateful to my colorist that she did such a good job and that she taught me like the right things to do when I am at home. So shout out to you, Marta. I love you, girl. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I'm so happy to finally have just got this out there for you guys because I've been learning so much about my hair. So I feel like it was the perfect time to put this out there. So as always, I want to thank you guys so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel because you know how much it means to me from the bottom of my heart. I love you guys so, so much and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!